The covenant of the torch, Genesis chapter 15, was ratified after Abraham had rescued his nephew Lot in the battle between the kings of northern and southern Canaan. And after his encounter with Melchizedek, Genesis chapter 14. It was also before Abraham took Sarah's maidservant, Hagar, Genesis chapter 16, whom he took after living 10 years in Canaan. Therefore, the covenant of the torch was ratified in Abraham's 10th year in Canaan in 2082 BC, when he was 84 years of age. The calculation of the year of the Exodus. The Exodus of the Israelites was the fulfillment of the covenant that God had made with Abraham. Through the covenant of the torch, God promised Abraham that his descendants would become strangers in a foreign land where they would be enslaved and oppressed for 400 years and return in the fourth generation, Genesis chapter 15 verse 13. The question that arises here is, when did the Exodus take place? To determine the year in which the covenant of the torch was established, we must calculate in reverse, starting from the year of the Exodus. There are two major theological methodologies for determining the year of the Exodus. The early date theory dates the Exodus to the 15th century BC, while the late date theory dates the Exodus to the 13th century BC. Many theological today support the early date theory. The late date theory presumes that the Exodus occurred during the reign of the Egyptian king Ramesses II, 1290 to 1224 BC. It also presumes that the prow who tried to kill Moses, Exodus chapter 2 verse 15, was the father of Ramesses II, Seti I, 1312 to 1289 before Christ. The early date theory presumes that the Exodus occurred in 1446 BC, during the reign of the Egyptian king Amenhotep II, 1450 before Christ. Thus, the pharaoh who tried to kill Moses would have been Thutmose III, 1504 to 1450 before Christ, from the 18th dynasty of Egypt. Many evangelical theologians support this view. Based on the Bible, the early date theory seems more appropriate than the late date theory, as suggested by the reasons below. The early date theory agrees with the historical record in 1 Kings chapter 6 verse 1. 1 Kings chapter 6 verse 1 states, "Now it came about in the 480th year after the sons of Israel came out of the land of Egypt, in the fourth year of Solomon's reign over Israel, in the month of Ziv, which is the second day month, that he began to build the house of the Lord." 2 Chronicles chapter 3 verse 2 cites the exact year, month, and date, "And he began to build on the second day in the second month of the fourth year of his reign." According to history, Solomon was enthroned as the king of Israel in 970 before Christ. Thus, the fourth year of his reign was 966 before Christ, adding 480 years in accordance with the record in 1 Kings chapter 6 verse 1, puts the Exodus at exactly 1446 before Christ. The late date theory perceives the 480 years as a symbolic number that represents 12 generations, 12 multiplication, 40 years. However, the advocates of the late date theory assert that one generation is actually only about 25 to 30 years. Accordingly, 12 generations would not amount to 480 years. The original Hebrew text of 1 Kings chapter 6 verse 1 makes no mention of 12 generations. Therefore, the late date theory holds little credibility. The early date theory agrees with Judges chapter 11 verse 26. Judges chapter 11 verse 26 states, "While Israel lived in Heshbon in its villages and in Aroer in its villages, and in all the cities that are on the banks of the Arnon, 300 years, why did you not recover them within that time?" Thus, 300 years passed from the beginning of the Canaan conquest until the time of Jephthah's reign, the period of the judges, which came after the conquest of Canaan, can be considered to be 340 years, because the time from the end of Jephthah's rule and beginning of King Saul's reign, which includes the prophet Samuel ministry, is considered to be 56 years. Then, adding to this 84 years and 6 months, the sum of 40 years of King Saul reigned. Acts chapter 13 verse 21, 40 years and 6 months of King David reigned. 2 Samuel chapter 5 verse 4, and 4 years of Solomon reigned. 1 Kings chapter 6 verse 1, would make the time between the conquest of Canaan and the construction of the temple of Solomon at least 424 years and 6 months. The Wilderness Journey, number 1433, and the period of the Canaan conquest generally are viewed as 40 years and 16 years respectively. Thus, adding 40-year-old and 16 years to 424 years and 6 months yields approximately 480 years. According to this calculation, therefore, it took 480 years from the time of the Exodus until the construction of the Temple of Solomon. Hence, the year of the Exodus becomes 1446 before Christ. 480 years plus 966 before Christ, the fourth year of Solomon's reign, and demonstrates that the early date theory is in agreement with the overall biblical standpoint. The calculation of the time of ratification. The Israelites entered Egypt in 1876 before Christ, adding 430 years the duration of the Israelites dwelling in Egypt. Exodus chapter 12 verse 40. Galatians chapter 3 verse 17. To the year of the Exodus results in 1876 before Christ as the Israelites entered Egypt. 1446 before Christ. Year of the Exodus plus 430 years equal 1876 before Christ. Jacob was born in 2006 before Christ. Jacob was 130 years old when he entered Egypt. Genesis chapter 47 verse 9. 1876 before Christ plus 130 years equal 2006 before Christ. Isaac was born in 2066 before Christ. Isaac was 60 years old when he became the father of Jacob. Genesis chapter 25 verse 26. 2006 before Christ plus 60 years equal 2066 before Christ. Incidentally, at the time of Isaac's birth, 2066 before Christ, Abraham was 100 years old. Genesis chapter 21 verse 5. The covenant of the torch was ratified in 2082 before Christ. Abraham took Hagar after having dwelled in Canaan for 10 years, when he was 85 years old. Genesis chapter 12 verse 4. Abraham was 86 years old when his Ishmael was born to him throughout Hagar. Genesis chapter 16 verse 16. Therefore, the covenant of the torch was ratified when Abraham was 84 years old before taking Hagar as his wife. This was 16 years before Isaac / birth. 100 minus 84 equals 16. Therefore, it can be deduced that 2082 before Christ was the year for the ratification of the covenant of the torch. 2006 before Christ plus 16 years equals 2082 before Christ.
This concludes today's message. Thank you very much. God bless you. I wish you have a good day.